Hey, it's lunchtime here, and I'm deciding to treat myself to that stuff that's called this is not bacon. Packaging that gives you reassurance that it's definitely not bacon. I have tried this before, but today I'm having BLTs. I haven't had BLT in fucking years. I've got two different. I tried to make them a bit different. That one's got tomato, that one's got ketchup and cheese in it, that one's just got salad. Like just lettuce and tomato, and that's it. No, a little bit of mustard, that's it. Now that bacon smells great, but does it smell too much like real bacon? That to me tastes exactly how I remember BLT tasting. Even when I'm cooking, I'm like, this is good, because it's one of the things that slightly annoyed me over the last few years, is that I do kind of get excited about the smell of bacon still. It's the only thing that, I think it's because it's smoked bacon, so it doesn't really taste or smell like the meat. We're going for a smoked taste. I had some other smoked vegan bacons that weren't particularly great. I had some rashers that kind of just burned and fell apart. But that does take me back. Especially when I used to go home on my lunch breaks and make BLTs. Like really quickly, and then run back to work. It's not like Vivera. They make very meaty tasting alternatives. Like, I even kind of... Well, we had their bacon bits on some pastas, like a carbonara thing. I just felt ill. The taste was so fleshy. I just couldn't get past it. But this doesn't taste fleshy. There's nothing fleshy about it. It literally is just that smoked taste. I mean, I like it. It's good. I'm going to keep eating that. I don't understand this need that a lot of people have. It kind of gives fire to non-vegans, anti-vegans, about how we approach alternatives to meat. And you know, the other day they were talking about, I think it was just yesterday, we were talking about this butcher shop that's like this vegan butcher's that's made out to look like a butcher shop. And I think that's not very forward thinking. That's just some bullshit hipster pop-up nonsense. Why on earth would you make a vegan butcher shop look like a... Surely you want to move away from the idea of butchery. You know, rather than just like making it actually seem like what people think it is being a fad, and it's not a fad. And it doesn't help when you've got people like celebrities in the public eye. They'll announce their veganism and then they'll denounce their being like, Mike Tyson, he needs to eat meat so he can beat some dude in a fight. I don't really see how that's necessary. Miley Cyrus says that she needs the fish aisle for her brain. Yeah, so she went and started eating meat again. The best thing she could come up with is a Metallica covers album. So I don't really see what any of you are getting out of that. But I highly recommend, if you are vegan or going vegan or sort of thinking about it, and stuff like this is not bacon, this will get you through.